Hello students, this is Amardeep Singh, your computer teacher, and today we are going to continue with the same chapter of formulas, functions and charts. In this session we'll discuss about graphics and auto shapes in Excel. So let's discuss what are auto shapes available in Excel. The auto shape feature of Excel allows you to draw a number of geometrical shapes, arrows, flowchart elements, star or more on the worksheet. So that means with the help of auto shape we can draw different type of graphical shapes on the body of a worksheet. So if you want to use any or all the auto shapes, then you have to click on insert tab, then under the illustration group you will find auto shape shapes option available in that one. So these are the various auto shapes and these are the various categories of auto shapes available in Excel. So first we are having lines. This category contains different type of lines like straight lines, arrow lines, curved lines also. Then basic shapes are also available here, like these rectangle, this face smiley shape or any other. And a flowchart. If you want to draw some kind of flowchart, then flowchart elements are available in this category. And next we are having callouts. These are the callout symbols available in that is cloud or in so many different type of symbols are there. Then connectors are there. Connectors are used to connect one part of a shape to another part, like we are having in flowcharts to connect all the elements of a flowchart. Then block and arrows are there, and in this category you will be able to draw different types of arrows. Then stars and banners are here. Let's briefly discuss about the auto shape categories. First we are having, as in previous slide we have discussed about those categories. Let's start with the discussion of those categories. First we are having lines. After clicking on line button, the auto shape toolbar draw a straight line, arrow or a double ended arrow or a curved line also. So as we have discussed earlier, that we with the help of this line option you will be able to draw straight or curved lines also. And the connectors, these lines can be used to connect flowcharts. So that means if you want to connect flowchart boxes, then you will be then you can do this that by using the connectors. Then next, basic shapes are there. Click on the basic shape button on the auto shape toolbar to select from many two and three dimensional shapes, icons, braces, brackets. So these type of shapes are available in basic shapes. So I can show you also. These are the basic shapes. So here we are having brackets, moon shape, star shape, then heart shape, smiley shape, and so many different type of shapes are available here. And next we are having block arrows, right? And select block arrow to choose from many types of two and three dimensional arrows. So with the help of this option you will be able to draw the arrow shapes on the body of a worksheet. Here we are having different type of arrows available in auto shapes. And after that we are having flowchart. Choose from the flowchart menu to add a flowchart element. So if you want to draw a flowchart, a flowchart contains a box, oval shapes for starting and stopping a process, diamond shape for decision making, and connector arrows to connect all the elements of a flowchart. So if you want to draw a flowchart, then you can use this category. Then stars and banners are there. Click the button to select a star, bursts, then burst and banners and scroll. So if you want to draw star shapes on the body of that particular spreadsheet, then you can use that this category of auto shape. Next we are having callouts. select the speech and thought bubbles. So that means with the help of callouts, then you will be able to add speech and thought bubbles and line callouts, right? So if you want to display thought bubbles with some kind of graphical shape, then you will be able to use these speech or thought bubbles in from auto shape option available in Excel. So these are the various categories of auto shapes available in Excel. So let's demonstrate how to draw graphical shapes on a worksheet. Then first of all, you have to click on insert, and inside this illustration groups, we are having option shapes. So with the help of this option, you will be able to draw graphical shapes on a worksheet. Then here we are having the categories of all the categories of auto shapes that we have already discussed. Here we are having lines, if you want to draw a straight line or an arrow line, then you can draw it with the help of using, for example, here we are having a straight line. Or if you want to draw a straight after you will to draw a curved line, then even that is here, that is curved line or connector. With the help of this one, you will draw it like this. And in curved line, if you want to change the size of this line, then here we are having two pointers, and you will be able to drag these pointer to increase or decrease the size of that line. And in case of curved line, we are having three pointers. This one, these are to resize or resize the line or rotate a particular line. And this symbol is used to change the shape of that curve, the line like this. So that option is available. And when you will select any particular shape, then a format menu or tab will be there, by using which you can change the color, or you can change the shape, or also any outlining shape or such kind of things from this option. So by using these options, you will be able to select. So just click outside, and again click on insert, shapes are there. Next we are having rectangle shapes. When a round rectangle is there, then normal rectangle is there. If you want to draw rectangle, then you can see this like this, right? And again, when you will draw a rectangle, format option will be there. Then you will be able to change the color of that rectangle. So if you want to write anything inside this rectangle, then you have to right click, then edit text, then you will be able to write anything inside that rectangle or inside any other shape also. So as I have specified the Cambridge inside that rectangle, and so this one is a rectangle. And again click outside, then click here. After rectangle, we are having some basic shapes are there. If you want to draw some shape here, like I want to draw a smiley shape, then just draw that shape on that one. And with the same options, you will be able to change the color of this shape also. So again, next click outside and click on shapes, and the block arrows are here. I want to draw this arrow, then you will be able to draw such kind of arrow on a spreadsheet. And you will be able to, if you want to change the color of that arrow, then again format to tab is there, and you can click on any but any shape or any style, then the shape will be style will be changed according to that particular option. Just click outside. Now if you want to remove, then select all these things, then select one thing and press delete from keyboard if you want to remove all the shapes. And again, if you want to draw any other shape, like equation shapes are there, I want to draw this multiplication symbol, then click outside. Then other flowchart shapes are there, like if you want to draw a decision making, then by using this diamond symbol, you can draw a decision making symbol. Then again click on shapes. Then star and banner shapes are there. If you want to draw some star or anything else, then just draw that shape. And if you want to write the text inside that star, then right click and edit text. Then you will be able to draw something inside that shape in this way. And again click outside. Then next we are having these callouts to draw a thought bubble. So if you want to draw a thought bubble, then click that, and in this way you will be able to draw that thought bubble. And even if you want to add text, then right click and edit text, then you will be able to draw some kind of text inside that particular shape. So these are the various options available in shapes, and these are the various categories available inside the shape. And if you want to draw any of this shape, then you have to click on again insert, then inside illustration, then you have to click on shape button. So in this way you will be able to draw any kind of shape on the body of a worksheet. So if you people are having any kind of doubt related to auto shape and how to draw a auto shape, then feel free to contact me anytime.